There's a black hole at the heart of biology. Everything that's in all your cells that make your complexity possible, we do not know what the forces were that gave rise to it evolving in the first place. Life has a peculiar and unexpected architecture. People just assumed it would be chemistry, and it turns out to be fundamentally electrical. The actual strength of the electrical field is 30 million volts per meter, so that's equivalent to a bolt of lightning. We inherited that charge in the eggs from our mother. There's a continual, unbroken electrical charge down billions of years in our own cells today. That charge has never flickered, it's never gone out. So what we have in our own cells is a difference in proton concentration between one side of a membrane and the other side of the membrane, which gives a charge across that membrane. We see exactly the same thing down in these vents at the bottom of the ocean. These vents, they're not belching out very quickly, they're wending their way rather gently through this labyrinth of pores. The first cells may have formed within these vents, taking advantage of the natural proton gradients, and then about 2 billion years ago, one cell got inside another cell and changed the whole structure of cells. And very often cells will snuggle up together. And we see this all the time, that's completely normal. What's not normal is for one of those cells to snuggle up so hard it actually gets inside. That's very unusual. It's only this freak moment when one cell gets inside another cell, changes the architecture, releases this energetic charge, and allows things to become large and complex. All of the complex life we can see goes back to a common ancestor where that had happened. And probably, of all these thousands of occasions where it may have happened, we only know one example where it really worked out. That only happened once in this whole 4 billion year history of life. Are we really as improbable as it looks that complex life only arose once in 4 billion years? That's the vital question.